Let's take a look at the atomic structure for neon, that's Ne on the periodic table. What we'll do is use a Bohr diagram here, also called a Bohr model, to visualize the structure, the atomic structure for neon. Neon has the atomic number of 10, and what that means is that neon is going to have 10 protons. Atomic number, that's the number of protons. So neon has 10 protons in the nucleus. For neutral elements, and all of the elements listed on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral. The number of protons, that equals the number of electrons. So if we have 10 protons in the nucleus of the neon atom, we have 10 electrons in the energy levels around it. What we want to do is figure out where these electrons are in the different energy levels. Neon has two energy levels. Let's use the periodic table to do that. So we said neon has 10 protons, since it's neutral, 10 electrons. So we go to the first period on the periodic table. This is the first energy level. We have 1, 2 electrons. So we're going to put them right here in the first energy level. And now that first energy level, that's full. We have to go to the second energy level. In the second energy level, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we can have up to 8 electrons in the second energy level. We have 2 here. We need 10 total. So we're going to put 8 electrons in the second energy level, 2, 4, 6, 8, right there in the second energy level. This energy level is full. That's why we say neon is a noble gas. Its highest energy level is full. We call these electrons out here in the highest energy level valence electrons, and they're really important because they're involved in chemical bonding. Since neon has a full outer shell, highest energy level, it won't form chemical bonds because its outer shell is full. That's why we call it a noble gas. If you need help writing the electron configuration for neon or looking at the number of neutrons, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the atomic structure for neon, and we used a Bohr diagram or a Bohr model to help us visualize that. Thanks for watching.